Hey, what's up, guys? It's Rissole here. We're doing Moon today. Let's see what our perk it is. It's speed, alright, so we can't get Jug here. We'll just get a point up. But, yeah, Moon. Moon is so... I don't know why. I thought the general reception of Moon was that it was good, but apparently it's one of those maps you either love or you hate. I absolutely love this map. I think it's really good. And it was a really cool conclusion they had set up for it. I thought it was great. Blowing up the Earth, I was not expecting that. Just the effects that had on the story. You know, it made us go into the future and all that. And despite what anyone says about Transit, I still think the atmosphere was pretty cool. But Moon, you know,
where the hell are we?
I love the look of it. I think they got it right. So good. And, you know, the whole biodome, that's, like, a really cool, like, they've got this glass dome full of air. And the story reveals, like, with Samantha going into the MPD, like, if you listen to the radios and all that, reveals a ton of backstory, and it's, like, just gives you some good context and all that. And, I was really... There's nothing really wrong with this map, honestly. The Easter egg was great. The Easter egg, I still think, is probably the best Easter egg. It's got a good, like, reward for it being the last map. So best reward, the steps, they're not too bad. The only ones that are bad are the luck-reliant ones, which is waiting for Excavator Pie to come down. And, of course, you know, getting the wave gun and Gersch Device and QED and all that. But apart from those, it was just really good. I love... the whole Simon Says thing and using that. The hacker was really cool as well. I thought it was an ingenious idea, like using it to get stuff for cheap and flipping wall weapons so that pack-a-punch ammo would cost cheap. I thought that was so cool. And you know, people think like, oh, that's way too OP, but it really isn't, because the wall weapon spots are in like pretty bad places, especially ones that are outside. It's very hard to use the hacker on them. And they're just the spots are in there, not really good long term. I was hoping it wouldn't smash the windows. Did I even get damage any of them? Whatever. Doesn't matter. The hacker was really good. I love the effects of it and how you would just like, you could wait a long time to open doors, you could give perks back. It's basically what the big guy is unburied, but they just decided, you know, we'll make him a person instead. What is it? It can do power-ups as well, that's right. The strategy is, like, you throw a Gersch device every 3 rounds or something like that, and then you get a power-up in that, and then you switch that with... you use the hacker on that, so you'll get... max ammo, so you're replenishing your Gersch devices. So it's kind of like a never-ending cycle, basically. Alright, PM63. I don't really go Tunnel 11 way. I'm usually always go Tunnel 6, just because that's where the Easter egg kind of starts. I usually just wait, like... it kind of changes. Sometimes I wait till Tunnel 6 is breached before I even try the egg, because if you're doing all those steps and then Tunnel 6 gets to like round 30 and it hasn't breached yet, it's like, you know, what's the point? It gets way too late. I thought the difficulty and the other steps were alright. And also, it doesn't require 4 players. You can actually do it with 1. You could technically do it solo. The problem is in solo, for some reason, Richtofen or whoever's got the cord, they just can't place the cord connecting the Moon computer base to like the charge up the focusing stone or whatever, or the real generator. Just like they charge just didn't allow it. But you know, if you've got a second player, you know, you could technically do all the steps. If you're a Richtofen, you could technically do all the steps by yourself. You don't need anyone else to help you. I mean, sure, it'll take longer because you've got to switch between Gersch device and QED. But, you know, you can still do it by yourself. So, I don't know. That's why I consider it the best, honestly. And also, we got to see Samantha for like the first time ever, which is really cool. You know, you got this giant pyramid, and then it opens up and reveals Samantha, and it's got all this like goddess music and divine music and all that crap. And it's just, I thought it was really cool, honestly. The one thing it's probably, it's not bad, but one of the weaker points of Moon, the song. I don't hate Coming Home. I think it's an alright song, but I felt Elena. I used to call her Elena before I found out it was pronounced Elena. So I thought Elena's screams were a bit forced. They sent them really forced, and I thought the screaming was a bit too much. I think she does good screaming in little increments, but not like to the point that she was doing it in Coming Home, because that was just a bit too much for me. But the chorus is good. The chorus is good, and I think possibly it's also a very basic song. There's not much to it. It's just like kind of a generic verse, chorus, bridge, chorus again. I feel like maybe this might not have been the song for when this map was Paris, because originally Moon was going to be Paris. If you look at the developer name on PC, it's like ZM Dev Map Paris or something like that. So Moon was going to be Paris, and I'm pretty sure the most of the layout would have been like how it would have been in Paris. So I reckon the giant ravine where the rockets are in, I reckon that would have been like the river, like, or something. It would have been a river. Oh my god, of course I got this. Oh well, it'll get me points. It would have been a river, and this would have been like the catacombs or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, I just think, like, I reckon there was probably a different song that Kevin had done. And then when they changed it to Moon, he had to probably put something quickly together to make it kind of fit Moon. Alright, well, we can't buy that yet. It's okay, I'm just going to survive the sniper. I want to go outside and get the AK-74U. Alright. Should go for headshots. I shouldn't hit their limbs. I need as much points as possible. Alright. I would have preferred the Dragunov, but this is a strong weapon. This will kill them at these low rounds pretty much anywhere, so... Oh, fuck. What is that, Max? Yes, thank you. Well, we got the PM63 now. What I don't like, though, is the ammo capacity of this gun. Clearly, they designed the Pack-a-Punch thing first, and then they're like, you know what, we need to give the gun, like, weaker ammo. It's not how they should do things. They should die in the single weapon by itself, and then give the buff to the Pack-a-Punch weapon. Not, like, design a good weapon around Pack-a-Punch, and then weaken its base weapon, because the ammo on this gun is pitiful. Only 100 on an SMG that shoots pretty fast. You can't dual wield it till, you know, you pack punch it. And I feel like it was made to be dual wielded, so I don't know. Pretty silly in my opinion. Alright, we got 750. Grab that. Why'd I grab that? I haven't turned the power on. Shit. Oh my god, I haven't turned the power on. I have not... Oh, fuck. Get me out of here. Fuck my life. I got that. I was just putting it on as well. I'll kill you because I cannot be bothered dealing with you today. Alright. That was fucked up. I forgot... There are times when I completely forget to turn the power on. I just go straight past it. Alright. We don't have quick revive now, so I gotta be careful. Come on.
At least we got that out of the way.
Actually, I'll hit the box again. Need the juice. And then we'll just camp here for a little bit. I don't want to go through the lab and get the gas zombies. QED. I want the QED. Fuck me. Come on, give me a good weapon. Less barfing. Fun. All right. Way to go. I don't have sound on, so I can't hear if it does anything. I hope it doesn't teleport me. Bonus points. Yeah, 600, not bad. Let's get a good gun.
Points for everybody. I think
what is that?
Crap is rubbing off on me.
Yes, yes. What is that? No! Oh my god, that was a fucking Gersch device. Fuck. Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, six rounds, that's like pretty shit. I didn't even get to the biodome. Or I didn't even get to Jug. Ah, fuck me. But Moon's still a good map. I didn't even talk about No Man's Land, but we're going to play No Man's Land another day, so I will talk about it there. Yeah, guys, we're going to do Transit tomorrow. We're moving on to Black Ops 2. Actually, no, we're not doing Transit tomorrow. We're going to do the World of War maps that are in Black Ops. So we're going to do Nocta on Totem, the Black Ops version, tomorrow. We'll go through to Dereese, and then we'll go move on to Black Ops 2, where we'll do Transit and all that stuff. All right, guys, I'm Rissole, and I'll see you later. Cheers.